Let's talk about this huge investment plan that you have hit this morning. My question is a straightforward one. Given the uncertainty that we see in the world right now, what gives you the confidence to make such a big commitment?
Well, first of all, we had to look 10 years down the road, which gives us a little bit of outlook on what in the energy world and where is this big transition driven by technology going, and where are we going with it? And what we saw as a wide open space for investment, a big case of renewables stronger than ever, and larger than before need of investment in networks that need to be resilient, flexible, and digitized in order to allow electricity to really take over the energy spectrum going forward. And I think that's where we got the courage, if you want to call it like that. But it's a very cool observation. This is where the world is going, where technology is driving us, where people are going themselves, and we better hurry and be there.
Francesco, how much of that is going to have to rely on M&A?
I think M&A is a part of it. In our case, we are going to be active in largely in the distribution, in from regulated assets on the distribution of electricity side. Areas of the world this is possible are enlarging. We've just seen India opening up for the sector to be privatized. We have Latin America being in that mode at the moment. I think large parts of Europe will start to look at distribution assets being put on the block. So there's a big part of M&A in play in the regulated asset distribution asset part.
Let's talk about the disposal side of that coin. Open fiber is the obvious place that I need to go to here. You talked on the call this morning about wanting to monetize that asset. Can you give me an idea of the time frame? Does that make it more imperative that you do monetize that asset? Where is the conversation with Macquarie at the moment in terms of the timeline?
I would say the conversation is at the very end, so there is not a time pressure at all. I mean, we are basically there. The issue is whether this is instrumental to the plan. Not really. I mean, it's a big opportunity, but in the context of the numbers you've just seen, it's just a tiny part. But certainly it is, if you want, a proof of the fact that then in a limited amount of time, we're talking about roughly 4 years, create a lot of value if you manage properly the combination between needs of a society, technology availability, and your platforms. And this is something that we call the stewardship model. This is a way of attracting and crystallizing investment from third parties, giving them the ability to and the access to skills and capabilities that we have. So we think it's a great achievement, not only because of the value created, but also because of the proof that this is a model that we can replicate over and over other times.
So let's get back to the open fiber though question. The market is really wanting to know some more deadline. Previously, it was talked about the end of November, potentially for a sale. And I hear you that it's only 2.65 billion euros, but there has been pressure from the Italian government to sell. Does that mean we can expect an announcement in the next week or so?
Announcement the next week. I mean, the announcement will be when we have finalized the deal, which is, like I said, question of weeks. I would say not next week, but question of weeks. So I will not give a deadline because it doesn't make any sense at this point. I think the government is happy to see that this venture, which is largely a government-driven project, has had this success, and that it can become a big instrument in further accelerating the digital transformation of the country on a wholesale, the third-party access guaranteed for every operator. So it's a big. Also, it's a big change from a regulatory standpoint at European level.
Francesco, I hate to dwell on the issue of the time frame, but it's something that we're really interested in finding out. Are we going to see this deal getting over the line by Christmas?
I'm not going to give you a deadline. You know that.
I have to try.
No matter how wonder how many letters I get.
Yeah. Is the government putting any pressure on you to get it done sooner rather than later? They are a big shareholder in your business, and and as they want to get the deal done. Do they want the deal done soon, or are they relaxed on the time frame?
We all want to have a deal done soon, but you know, deals need to be done properly, not soon. They need to be done properly. And so it's a question of just allowing, this is a deal of a certain dimension, and just a question of allowing a few more weeks to go by or a few more days, I don't know. But it's just at the end of it. I mean, it's just, so, there's no point in putting a deadline, honestly.
So put the deadline aside for a second. Can you give us an idea of what the holding points or sticking points are? I mentioned a potential price, 2.65 billion euros. Is that part of the issue or a conversation? What is it?
No, the price is not anymore a part of the conversation. It's past that. We're talking about tiny things, small details.
Okay, let's move back to the investment plan. And put aside that, because I think we've probably had what you're going to say on that matter. What do you need from government to make this investment? Clearly, there is an incentive around Europe to spend money at the moment. Where does that money need to be spent?
I think the money is already identified its own target. So it's even percentage wise defined. 37% at least must be green transition and stuff like that. So the direction where these investments are going is clear. It's green evolution of the economy of Europe, digital content, and job creation. These are the three big priorities that the Commission has several times reiterated to the various governments. So we're all in alignment with that. I mean, I think there is no discussion that this is a good idea. We also know, and this is the S part of the ESG acronym, that, you know, it's good for the society where this happens. I mean, it's creating jobs, it's decarbonizing, it's making life of cities more livable, so it's great. What is missing is that the tools we all have in Europe, but not only Europe, in general, in the world, to manage the complex project authorization processes that we have inherited from the past are no more in sync with the urgency we have in front of us. So there is a big need of addressing the G component of the ESG acronym. And look at the governance that today we have on the investment process of large infrastructures and take a hard look at it and say, is this at par with the ambition and the goals we are giving ourselves? And the answer is clearly no. It's too slow, it's too cumbersome, too complicated, and micromanaged. It has to be changed if we want to do the job in the right amount of time. And this is everywhere in Europe, no exceptions.
I was gonna wrap up with a question on M&A. Is it just Europe or is it elsewhere? Is it Asia? Is it Latin America?
It's Asia, it's America, not only Latin, it's also Europe. It's everywhere where we are.